When?
Yes.
Where?
No.
Sure.
Who?
Now.
What?
And that was our campus news reel.
Looks good, but we have lots more coming up, so stay tuned to Sight and Sound.
Stay tuned.
Hey kids, how's it going? I don't know if you caught the memo or not. I just was passing through. You know, you got a great buffet, by the way. It's illegal to say stay tuned on any other show on PSTV, but stay tuned. So sorry about that. What do you think?
Get a life, Joe?
Get a life.
Thursday night. The weekend's coming.
You're calling for a cab.
Yeah, I'd like two for downtown in front of
Mason Hall.
Things
you should know before you go downtown. One, the appearance. Okay, that takes a long time. The appearance. Ladies, you're not going to your 9 o'clock class. Bust off the sweatpants and like the flannel.
Put
the
hair hat away.
In a ponytail. What is that? The hat?
Guys are lying when they say they like that playful, natural, she looks so cute look.
Lying.
Take it off. Take it down. Head downtown. A little hairspray couldn't kill you.
Lipstick. Take care, brush your hair. I think, Abby, you should look presentable.
You know, while we're talking about downtown.
Yes.
Why don't we explain to some people what guys really mean when they're saying what they're saying?
That's good. Okay, that's good. That's good. Okay, how about, okay, how about this? It's 2 o'clock in the morning. The lights are going on. And a guy says, you know, I'd really like to get to know you better. Let's go home. They really mean,
I'm horny. You're the last person in here I haven't talked to yet. Could you pay for my cab ride?
Basically. Okay, number two. Can I get you a drink? They really mean,
I'm gonna get you loaded and you're coming home with me.
It's true. But anyway, take the drink anyway. You can always run to the bathroom and never come back.
That's right.
Always take the drink. Ladies, hello, take the drink. My God.
It's a cab ride home and a slice of pizza at Bono's.
Damn right, honey. Mm-mm-mm. What else? What else is downtown? Oh, ladies, it's 30 degrees. What are you doing running around with a t-shirt? Oh, never mind. I do the t-shirt thing. It gets hot in the bars. What can you say? Okay. Anyway, we're downtown. We're looking nice. We're having guys buy us drinks. It's 2 o'clock. You're going home with someone. I don't know. Have fun. Take care. Use a condom.
Yo, what up? Welcome to another episode of Lately Toasted. I am your cook extraordinaire, Joe Grill. How are you? Welcome to the show. We got a lot of great stuff. Special thanks, props go to my friend Phil. How are you, Phil?
How you doing? This is my kitchen. Very nice.
We're using Phil's kitchen because mine's kind of smelling pretty bad. You know, it's kind of funky. I wouldn't want you people to be subjected to that. So we're going to be making ramen noodles today. All right, cool. Thanks, Phil. We got the ramen noodles right here, also known as ramen or ramen, whichever you prefer. Sweet, cool. Now, one thing that some people will tend to do is break it apart into bits, and some people will kind of just like put it together as one brick. But that's up to you. That's entirely up to you, whatever you want to do with it. So today we're going to do, first of all, we're going to get the water boiling first. All right, so we got the water. Now we're going to put it right here on the stove. We'll start that right there we go. It's on high. Cool. You ever notice these things? I don't know what the hell these things are for. But every house has one, you know? I don't know what you use this for. It's just, it's been pretty hot out there today. Woo! This is my friend Janice, who lives next door. She borrowed my steak knives one time. I don't know why, but she took like 6 weeks to return them. And people were wondering what she was doing. I don't know. I didn't see anything, but hey, there were spots on them, and I don't know why. But this is the refrigerator. Got a lot of great stuff in there. Ragu's chunky. We don't use this in ramen noodles, but I just like saying, Ragu's chunky. Sweet. Can't believe I said that. Don't need the oven for this, so we don't need to do any preheating. Preheating. Don't need to do that, so don't do it. We're gonna wait for the water to boil, so we're gonna be right back. All right.
I'm Sue. I'm sitting here in downtown Plattsburgh on this crisp, windy day. I'm sitting here with Ben and Mike from White Man's Blues Band. How you guys doing today?
Doing all right.
Doing pretty good.
Hey. I saw you guys play. It was pretty different.
Going where the water tastes like wine. Well, I'm going where the water tastes like wine. Going where the water tastes like wine. Don't want to be treated this way.
Yeah, the whole harmonizing thing, you just got to get rid of that right away, you know.
You just don't want to conform.
No, definitely not.
Well, I think you guys are doing a good job of it, really. It's definitely... How do you get the inspiration for your songs? It's...
Well, we usually listen to songs that are good and then try to sound nothing like them.
Do the opposite, yes.
You know, I think it works. It really does. You have this obsession with... I've noticed you have an obsession with smoking.
I got up this morning, lit myself a cigarette.
Is that help your musical?
Yeah, because it's bad for you.
Impending cancer is...
It's doom. It's bad things.
It's
Are you looking for to get that voice? You know, that raspy voice.
Well, yeah, see, what Ben will normally do is drink a fifth of vodka before he goes up. That way he gets that rasp in his voice, you know.
He usually kicks me in the throat a couple times.
Drop kick.
Yeah. Breaking out of trouble.
My baby came to see me in jail. Lord, she took my money and sold my house.
Stole your house.
Stole my house. She backed over my dog with a lawnmower. I love that dog. I'm gonna kill her. She threw away my last pack of cigarettes. I'm off for parole next week. Don't think I'm gonna get it.
Okay. Everybody's getting ready to go to a party or something, and then there comes that dreadful knock on the door.
Oh, God.
Your friend comes in and gives you the old, do these jeans make me look fat? Do I look fat? And you're thinking,
my hips look square.
Oh, God. It's not the jeans, honey, that's making me look fat. It's your fat ass that's making you look fat.
But what do you say?
What do you say?
You can't say that.
So you just say, no.
No.
No. No.
You are not fat. You can never look fat. Fat? You? You're making me sick. I don't even want to talk to you anymore. Get out of here.
But, you know, I don't know, the whole purple pants thing, you know.
You don't look like Grimace.
No, no one would think Barney.
Barney?
No, God, no. Another thing, like, if, you know, not everyone's perfect. You know, like me. No, I'm just kidding. The whole, like, shirts going on, they're like hanging over.
Don't try this
really,
at home.
Don't do the shirt.
Tuck it in. There's nothing wrong with tucking
always
in a shirt.
Tuck your shirt
I
in.
Tuck my shirt
it's
in.
It's all out, it's all frumpy. I don't like that thing, you know? It's like, does this make me look fat? No. You're fat. Not they can make you look fat. The ring dings you're having for dinner every night, they make you look fat. But that's okay. So just remember, it's nice to be important, but it's important to be nice. Don't be mean to your friends.
Just saying.
All right, welcome back to Lightly Toasted. We're going around the room of my buddy Phil. How are you, Phil?
How you doing? How you doing?
All right, we're making ramen. In case you're wondering, we're making ramen. It's gonna be sweet. Excellent. This is your pad. This is where you hang out.
This is where I hang out. That's right.
Cool, man.
Got my bed up here. Got my desk down here. You see, got a lot of folks and everything.
Got your keyboards there. Got your racket, man.
Yep.
Swing a lot of balls.
I do. Yep.
Cool.
Yep. I do.
Cool. Darts, man. Can we like throw a couple? Throw a couple spears. Awesome. Take you on cricket, man. Stars and Stripes, man.
I'll take these.
All right, sweet. You know, I always like to fool some of the people that I have is just like unscrew the tip on them and you throw them at people. That's not cool, though, because you shouldn't do that because it's dangerous. But all right, cool. All right, we're going to be tossing some discs now, man. We're waiting for the water to boil. We got Phil. There you go. Whoa, hey. Cool. Don't want to tweak the melon. Whoa. Sweet. Oh. Welcome to Tide Country. Wow, I can't believe I did that. Whoa. All right, well, we're waiting for the water to boil, which I know you're pretty excited about, huh? Okay, what we're going to do is we're going to go down and look at the bathroom. Can we do that?
Sure.
Let's go look at the bathroom, man. Cool. Sweet. We don't want any floating logs in this one, but come on, man, anyway. That's pretty cool. Sweet. Whoa! That's not pretty sweet, dude. Whoa, let's go check that water.
Well, I'm going down the road feeling bad. Well, I'm going down the road feeling bad. Well, I'm going down the road feeling bad. Don't want to be treated this way.
Okay, so you've been together for 2 days now, and
10 minutes.
And 10 minutes, and you're doing pretty well. You've already played. You know, was this your first? This was your first, you know, gig.
Well, actually, no. When I met Ben, we were at a party. We were both pretty sloshed. My guitar was out in the truck. He had a harmonica on him, so we played at the party there, and it just felt right.
That's great. You just clicked like that.
Just clicked.
That's the best.
And actually, before the party,
I think there was a snap.
Definitely
a snap.
Definitely. A couple clicks, a couple snap, a click.
It worked.
A pop. There was a pop.
So what do we see in the future for White Man's Blues Band? Anything?
Oh, I'm hoping so. I really would like to quit my day job.
We're planning on an extensive worldwide tour of street corners everywhere.
And coffee houses.
And, well, after they threw hot coffee in my face at the coffee cat, I don't dig the coffee house
bad too scene, much anymore. Bad scene. Yeah. Anywhere's cold. I love the cold. I love playing outdoors. Somewhere's where I'm really uncomfortable. It brings out that sadness.
You feel better playing cold.
Yeah, but the worse the situation, the better. It really describes the blues.
Like the jitters, the shivers give you more of a musical.
You just got to be miserable.
Yeah, it's just any condition that'll piss you off basically works. Can I say that on the TV?
I got the can't hook up blues. I get dumped all over town.
Yeah, the band's not too bad. They're pretty cheap and they don't really get too much in the way. Besides that, they're okay. They're okay.
Maybe I'm gonna become a priest. Move to Bangladesh.
Yeah.
Okay, it's next morning. You had a good time downtown. But now it's time to wake up and... Oh my god, who did I wake up next to?
Oh, where am I?
How do we get rid of this problem?
Yeah. Waking up as a guy next to you. What do you do?
Hey, you can eliminate the whole problem by going home with him.
You can always pull the 5 o'clock in the morning.
I like to wake up in my own bed kind of thing.
Can you call me a cab, please? I really need to go home. I just, you know, I like my own bed. So that
eliminates all your problems right there. But sometimes you have a few too many. You end up at your place. Can't get rid of them.
What do you do?
Homework.
Yeah, I should have went out last night,
oh
man.
Oh my god, I didn't even do that paper. I can't believe it. That was so stupid. That was
meeting
stupid,
a group
stupid,
at like 9
stupid.
O'clock.
Let me call, make sure I didn't
miss
anything.
Yeah, oh my god.
Guys, I'll be there. I'm so sorry I'm late.
I really gotta go. I have to go. If that doesn't work, you can always pull the old...
I really, really like you.
I'm so glad. I mean, I really think we have something now.
Oh, yes.
I mean, you and me are just like so right on.
So right there.
So like, is there a commitment now? I mean, like...
Yeah. I mean, like...
I can't wait to tell all my friends about us. I'm gonna call my mom right now. I really want you to be my pet.
Can you do that?
See ya.
They're out of there.
Bye-bye.
Looks like a charm.
Or you could do number 3. You can call them the wrong name.
Mistake him for your boyfriend?
Oh, Ricky.
I'm Joey.
You know who are? We're really not being fair to the guys. Men, this works both ways. Except for the commitment thing.
Yeah. Some good.
But, what could men... Explain to the girl about the burning sensation you get when you urinate. We're out of there.
See you later. Even if it's our own room, we'll leave.
We'll leave.
You can do that. You can do the whole take your clothes, throw it out in the hall, say, get that out of there.
It does work though.
But
so there
you go.
Speaking of see ya.
We're out of here. Yeah. We gotta go downtown. We're gonna use all the tips that we gave you, and we are gonna have the best time
on a full kit.
Thanks. See you later.
Get you for downtown.
Take a chance on something, star. You got.
Oh, hey, how's it going? Bung the lightly toast? Never mind the smell here. Had tacos earlier. Original Pam, flavored and natural. Waiting for the water to boil? Tell you an interesting story. These are called time fillers.
Cool.
We ran out of dish soap one time. We had this major party. Guys came over, drinking beers all over the place. There was just stuff everywhere. So we brought in the Dawn, and we just started like scrubbing place down because like landlord was coming like in 3 hours because it was like a Sunday, you know, because we had the party on Saturday night. Scrubbed the place down with the Dawn, and actually worked, man. We were stoked. It was cool. The place was clean. Landlord was happy. Gave him money. That was it. No questions asked. That was pretty cool. Did you like that? Cool. Lightly toasted. I tweaked my do, man. Cool. But don't forget to take out the flavor packet. Cool. So then we'll put this right in the water, right like this. Want every nook and cranny in there. It's gonna be nice. Where's your garbage, Phil?
Right over here.
Cool. Excuse me, James. They're right there. Mug root beer. Sweet. Should we use the fork? Wow, this is a big fork, man. What the heck do you fork with this? So my buddy Larry and I, one time we got kind of sick. So what we decided to do was make ramen noodles and just kind of breathe in the broth from the ramen noodles. It worked, dude. It was gone in a week. Go figure. You're living with a bunch of guys. There's always some people that use so many ice cubes that, you know, they're gone like within hours. But then, whoops, look out for that guy. He wanted to get out of there real quick. Get my water here. I forgot to go shopping. I'm just sorry. I usually have something better, like Sprite or something, but water's fine. Good water, Bill. Develops itself into a soup. All right, we'll put this back over here. Doesn't that look yummy? That's very watery. Is it supposed to be this water? I don't know. Is it? We have the flavor packet. Please tear along this line.
So we will.
There we go. Put that right in there. Now we should like take a survey. How many people call it ramen and how many people call it ramen? I'd like to know. Ramen's a name, you know. Imagine if your name was Raymond Ramen. Boy, what hell you'd go through in life.
That's weird.
Let's get that on the mic, man. This will be sweet audio. Sweet. And the sinuses are cleared. Sweet. It's all in Japanese. What the hell did I drink? Sounds like waterfalls in the Pacific. When I have a headache this big.
Good.
So good, it's almost...
You did it again.
So good, it's almost home cooked. Alright, we'll see you later. Give that to the dog.
I think that's it.
We're done. We're done. Thanks for tuning in. We'll see you later. How are you? We're right here at WPLT 93.9 FM in Plattsburgh, New York, which happens to be our college radio station. It's open house day. Let's go in and open the house. Hey, kids, how's it going?
Hi, Joe.
Would you care for some sandwiches?
Could we?
How's the open house going?
Good.
Pretty good. Yeah. The finance guy was here.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Did he bring his wallet?
No, I asked him for $5, but there was nothing doing.
He did give me their checkbook.
Ooh, cool. Did you offer him a sandwich?
Yes, we did.
Yeah, did he take it?
No.
Yeah, what's this?
We weren't persuasive enough.
There you go. That's yours.
Hey, thanks.
You own it. All right, let's go over here.
Can you eat that?
See who else is here. That probably sounded sweet on the audio, huh? Hey, we got sandwiches. Hi. Would you care for a sandwich?
I've already had my share. I think I ate like 3 of them earlier today.
Yeah?
Can you tell me putting on the
weight? Ah.
We've
got roast beef. Look, it's got doilies. Say doily.
Doily.
Nice to say doily. You like to say doily?
Doily.
You like to say doily. All right, let's go see if anyone else wants the sandwiches.
We've got sandwiches.
Let's go. Hey, did you kids eat? Would you care for a sandwich?
What are they?
Meat and stuff.
Hell, I love them.
Yeah, go ahead, have one. They're free.
Meat and stuff.
Meat and stuff sandwiches.
What kind of stuff?
Courtesy of WPLT.
What kind of stuff?
Stuff that's filling.
Filling?
Go ahead and dig right in there.
Those mad cow disease things, is it?
Maybe not, but I don't know. I'd still get a treatment for that. Would you care for a sandwich?
No, thank you.
On a diet?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. We kind of saw that coming. How are you? Want a sandwich? No sandwich? Hi, Dr. Kim. Would you care for a sandwich?
This is another gimmick.
Another gimmick.
Another gimmick, just like that hair.
Yeah, you're a recurring character now.
Oh,
aren't
my,
you thrilled?
I had a sandwich for my lunch, and yeah. I'm afraid I have to turn this down.
There's meat and stuff.
Your tax dollars at work?
Hey, state workers.
State workers.
I was a state worker once. I know what that's like. A lot of sleep. Got a lot of sleep that summer. Sandwich? Who wants a sandwich? We've got sandwiches, damn it. Care for a sandwich? Have a sandwich. Have a sandwich.
Care for a sandwich.
You want a sandwich,
oh,
don't
Joe,
you?
Oh, Joe, I've eaten so many.
Oh, you gotta be kidding me. What kind of sandwich is this?
Where's
meat,
the mail?
Meat sandwiches and
Where's
stuff.
Where's the mail?
I thought you were supposed to get the mail.
No. The mail.
The mayo?
You're right.
Oh, we forgot the mayo.
Look, I'm even gonna eat one.
Look, he's gonna eat a sandwich.
I'm gonna eat it. You ready?
Get the sound effect.
Hey, you know what?
What?
It's a little toasty on this.
It's a little toasty. There's a satisfied customer. You're enjoying the sandwich, aren't you?
Mm-hmm.
Would you care for a sandwich?
No, okay.
Are you sure?
Yes.
You like being on TV, don't you?
I love it.
Okay, I'm gonna go over here. Ooh, watch this. We can do our own news brief. See? Get a shot of this, Matt.
Good evening. For PSTV News Briefs, we've got sandwiches.
There's no cheese.
No. Well, someone must have picked it off. No?
No, thanks.
These are good for fiber. Here, go ahead. Wait, watch this. There you go. Now you're styling. Have that. You. That's yours. You own it.
Thank you.
All right. Appreciate we'll go over here. Guys want sandwiches? We've got sandwiches.
Where'd you get sandwiches from?
They think I'm an idiot. Can we put like a sandwich in like a videotape machine and see if it plays something?
Yeah, aren't you due for a diploma in May?
I'm supposed to be graduating. All right, we'll get back out of here right now because we don't want anything to disrupt that. Shall we go outside? America, we have sandwiches. Ooh, there's cheese. See, look at that. They thought there was no cheese.
Bread for that needs. Meal.
Wait, look, we've got an extra slice. There we go.
Mix that up.
That looks. Wait. See, it's all in the presentation. They're free. Oh. Nutritious, too.
I'm vegetarian.
I just wouldn't eat that right there because I don't know where that's been. That's been through the war. But you're welcome to the other ones. Is that Melissa's car?
Yes.
Are you sure?
Uh-huh.
Let's leave her a sandwich. Would you care for a sandwich?
Yeah, I'll take a sandwich.
Sure, you seem like you've been working hard or skateboarding all day. Just stay away from that one right there.
Yeah, that one looks kind of nasty.
Yeah. It's free.
Yeah, hey, thanks a lot.
There you go. Compliments of SUNY Plattsburgh.
Gotcha.
Have fun.
Hey, you too.
Yeah, ready. They love me. Hey, do you know what that thing is, by the way?
I don't know.
Some sort of head or something, but there's so much stuff in there, I think we got to add to it. Roast beef. Excuse me, sir. Would you care for a sandwich?
I don't know. They look pretty disgusting, but maybe just a piece of bread.
There you go. That's all yours.
Mm, that's good bread.
Have fun. Thanks for shopping, Walmart. Shh. What is this stuff? There's a guy working in that yard. Maybe he knows. We're just wondering if this stuff is actual memorabilia from the Sanford and Son set.
Of course it is.
Ah, great. So what is, are you cleaning the house or something?
We're cleaning house.
Yeah. Is this supposed to be like the, what is this stuff exactly? Like, got rusted metal. That's a group, rusted metal. Look, among the artwork, sandwiches. Ooh, God, okay. Do you like doilies?
A little bit.
You it's know. Fun to say doily.
There's
plenty of them. Doily. Look at that. A doily sandwich.
Nice.
Would you care for a sandwich?
I love a sandwich.
Mike?
Thanks very much.
It's all you.
Free?
Free.
Don't have to pay for these?
Nope.
I'm getting free food all the whole day.
We've got sandwiches. Come on. Land on the tray. It'll be funny. Anyone care for a doily? We're giving away doilies. Okay, cool. They're full of doilies. These things. It's fun to say doily. Doily? Anybody?
Okay.
Yeah, they don't care. They, you want a doily? You win. Want me to sign it?
Please, would you,
sure.
Graduating, right?
Yeah, I'm graduating. I'm out of here.
No.
Would you like to give a doily to someone you love? Here, just a little token of PSTV. It makes it all the more authentic. There you go. Okay. We got to give this tray back. Alrighty. You've said doily, what, 17 times? Oh, boy. Thanks for watching. I'm going to take a big nap.
Me.